That's Loud and Clear by Striper. As you can tell, it doesn't sound exactly like what they do. And things are not always as they seem, are they? So I've been playing guitar for many years, and it doesn't sound like it, as you can tell. And it didn't really come very natural to me, you know. I can play, you know, chords all day long, you know, power chords. But to be able to play lead is not my forte. But I practice at it every single day. And things are all not always as they seem. Now, I'm a professional drummer. That's my thing. But I enjoy playing the guitar as well. And, you know, some things have transpired in the last couple of weeks that got way out of control. And, you know, they all came to a head, and there was a meeting, and there was forgiveness, and there was reconciliation. And I seem to still think some of the things that happened actually happened. But, you know, when you have a few people that really convince you otherwise, there's a point when it comes to where you just let it go. Blessed is the peacemaker. And I got to the point where I knew that I knew what I had heard. I knew what was what. But I made peace, and I've moved on. And you have to forgive. You have to forgive in order to move on. And it's been a tough thing, because all my life I've had to give in, and I've had to have that humility. And it just seems like I don't remember a time where it ended up where I won the argument, or it came out in my favor. I just don't. It may have. It just has happened so little in my life. And because I'm the kind of person that doesn't have the real quick wit and the real quick words, I get taken advantage of a lot. And so I sit there in the mornings and I talk to the Lord, and I'm like, I guess this is what I am cursed with. And what I have been hearing is He gives grace to the humble. And it took me a while to really understand, what grace is He talking about? When I'm humble and I keep my mouth shut and I just do, I just let people do what they want to, even in the church, you will get attacked. And this is not an attack on the church. Understand where I'm coming from. The enemy will use your brothers and sisters in the church to attack you. Where you feel the most safe, and you let your guard down, and then somebody comes along and knocks you down, and you're like, where did that come from? I didn't expect this. And it's not the church's fault. It's the people sometimes, okay? And the enemy will use people, and a lot of times they don't even know they're being used in that way, until you approach it and you fix it and you say, hey, this is the way I'm feeling. And I knew I would be discarded today, disregarded. I knew that, even though they said, we know your feelings are real, but that means, but you're still wrong. Okay. Well, where is the grace? How does that fit in? It's probably fitting in times when I fall down and I don't do what's right. And God has given me that grace because I've been humble. I don't know. But there's times when He should have just left me on the side of the road, and He didn't. And I am very thankful He didn't. And so if you get nothing out of this video today, get this one thing: that God gives grace to the humble. And you may seem like you lose every battle, but you're not going to lose the war, because giving up, leaving your church, going somewhere else, that doesn't solve anything. And in fact, it makes things worse, because if you are going to still end up leaving, you did not leave on a good note. And so I think that's where it's at. So other than that, y'all have a great day. Okay.